I think a couple things just off the bat. First of all, you know, I think the natural question is, well, how are we going to respond? How are we going to be? And if a Wednesday practice, you know, 12, 13 weeks into the season is any indication of the type of team we have, these guys were awesome today. They competed like crazy, really energized. It was very cool. You know, on a day, November 26th, day before Thanksgiving, it's 80 degrees out, and our guys are flying around playing football, having fun with each other, which is really cool for me. It's a great opportunity to get some of the families out, watching them practice. Some of the families that haven't been able to get to practice during the regular season were able to come out today and made for a really good environment for practice. So, all in all, a good Wednesday as we prepare ourselves for Saturday.
Not that you want guys to be all out tackling when they're not in pads, but what Leonard did to Tolan there, does that kind of a tone-setting type of move there that
well,
can have a positive effect?
I think all of that was started yesterday, too. I mean, our guys are really physical in yesterday's practice. Came back and did it again today, and that's what it's going to take Saturday. It's going to take a really physical performance. Notre Dame's a very physical football team. And as we have navigated through the season, we're obviously still trying to find aspects of our game to improve upon. And I think that that is one aspect that we can. And you know, I would like to think that by making it a real point of emphasis, that we'll reap the benefits of it Saturday.
When you look at the Dolphins, kind of had his fair share of turnovers this year.
Sure.
How much does that emphasize and mean when you've been out here on the practice?
Well, you need to be aware of it. We need to be aware of the amount of tip balls that he's had and that have led to some turnovers. We need to be aware of some of the fumbles. But we also need to be aware of his playmaking ability. We need to be aware of the fact that he's thrown 29 touchdown passes this season. He's a very dangerous player. But yeah, I mean, when the ball becomes, the ball's as valuable to us as it is, as we've seen, you know, plus +9 on the year, and we have some, we think we could have some opportunities to get some, we want to make sure we take advantage of it.
Can you be too overzealous? Or can the guys be too overzealous in trying to force those turnovers?
I think the first thing is we have to defend them and defend their offense and defend Everett in all aspects of his throwing, of his designed runs. They call quite a bit of designed runs for him and his scramble. So we have to defend him, one. But two, you know, when the moment of truth comes to the ball's getting thrown, I'm a defensive lineman. I can't be, you know, I can't be negligent and just not decide to get my hands up, because there's been so many tip balls. We need to try to take advantage of it. The ball has been knocked out of his hands and on the ground. When we're there to make the tackle, we need to try to take advantage of it.
Any update on Bryce Dixon with the concussion?
He was better today. He's making the proper strides to be prepared to play Saturday. He is not fully cleared, but he was able to do more today. So obviously, there's a process with when you have concussion symptoms. There's a process to it, and so far he's on pace to be ready to play.
Is Notre Dame, why have they struggled the past month? They're still in every game, but why are they?
Well, I mean, ask me the same question about us. You know, I mean, they had a couple games where they just didn't finish the way they had been finishing early in the year. You know, they lost a heartbreaker there to Florida State, literally on the last play of the game. They lose a heartbreaker there, obviously, 2 weeks ago to Northwestern in overtime. They lose a tight ball game a week ago by 3 to Louisville. So, you know, the teams that can go, you know, 12-0, 11-1, 10-2, they find a way to win those games at the very end. And we're two teams that, unfortunately for us, have found a way to lose a couple of those games at the very end. I'd love to be here as a 10-2 football team or a 9-2 football team right now. Instead, we have 4 losses. I think they're in a very similar boat. So they're still really good. They're still very well coached. They still have excellent players. And it should be a great game Saturday.
Hindsight being what it is, when you look at your team, are those close losses, new staff, new changes? Are those close losses, hey, we're down players and we're gassed at the end?
No, I think it's just a matter of making it more of an emphasis. And as I reflect after every game and I evaluate every game from myself to our staff to our players, I do the same thing at the end of every season. And then you focus on the things that you think you really can improve upon all off season long, throughout spring ball, into the summer, into next year's training camp, to improve on the areas that you weren't as good at, and then to continue to get better at the areas where you can improve and get better at. That area of the game is obviously an area where we can improve, and it'll be a huge point of emphasis of ours when we come back in January for the next 9 months leading up into next season.
If this is the final game for Leonard at Coliseum, what kind of example has he set for people that when they do leave early?
Well, I think the great thing for Leonard is this. We touched on it earlier. It's a Wednesday practice in nearly December. It's 80 degrees out. We go to team run, and the second play he picks up the running back and body slams him. You know, he only knows one way to play the game. And I think in this day and age of guys reading their names in every potential mock draft and where they're supposed to go and All-American status, we see so many guys maybe not go as hard all the time, maybe, you know, take themselves out and whatnot. Leonard Williams has not done that once this year, and he's not been 100% healthy, but he comes out and he works his tail off, he plays his tail off, and we're thankful for that.
Speaking of thankful, tomorrow's Thanksgiving. When you think about that, what's the first thing that comes to mind you're thankful for?
Oh my gosh, there's a lot. Good health. You know, good health for myself, my family, my friends, our players. And that's something that a lot of times is out of our control. And so, I'm always thankful for that. But, I'm thankful I get to come out and coach football at USC tomorrow at 9:45 in the morning, whatever it is. So there's a lot to be thankful for, and obviously we'll address that as a team. We've got a little homework assignment we're doing tonight individually, and we'll make sure that we are thankful for the necessary things that we should be thankful for.
What is that homework assignment?
That we're all going to write down what we're thankful for, and we'll go through it in the team meeting tomorrow, because we need to recognize in life the things that we're thankful for, and we should be gracious that we have and humble that we have.
Do one more Thanksgiving dish.
Oh my gosh. Look at me. I like it all.
Apple pie is what you're saying?
I don't know.
Good?
Alrighty, guys. All right, see you in the morning.